Good morning, everybody. Last time we have to explain laser. Laser stands for light amplification of stimulated emission by radiation. So, in case of laser stimulated emission, the process is an excited electrons or molecules interact with a photon, decays to an available lower energy level. The stimulated emission is the process of excited electrons or molecules. And in this process gives a photon. The atom is in excited state, move towards ground state, that is E1. If the atom is triggered due to an action of incident photon, the interaction between the excited atoms and incident photon trigger the excited atom to make excited to ground state as shown in diagram. Then application of laser. It is used, laser is used welding, cutting, surveying, garments industry. Laser is used in the nuclear fusion, communication, laser printing, CDS and optical disc. Laser is used spectroscopy, heat treatment, barcode, scanner, laser cooling. Laser is used to transfer data from one computer to another computer. So this is important for you because data inside the computer transfer from another computer. So student, this is the application, and generally this application is very useful in your daily life. Keep in your mind. Next application of laser. Laser is used to control heat treatment. Laser is used to detect or flaw in a material. So, this is the application of laser. Then, population inversion. So, what is mean by population inversion? The population is number of active atom. This is the important words in this definition. Population is the number of active atoms. Population of higher excited state greater than lower excited state. Population of higher excited state greater than lower excited state. Population of active electrons in higher energy level more than population of active electrons in lower energy level is called population inversion. Population inversion of active electrons in higher energy level, that is E2, more than population of active electrons in lower energy E1 is called population inversion. In this case, population of lower energy level is high, that of higher energy level is low. So, as shown in diagram, so this is the activated energy level diagram, keeping your mind. So, here is, this is the upper level and this is the lower level. In population inversion, to produce the stimulated emission properly, population of higher excited state should be greater than lower energy level or excited state. Then active medium. Active medium is a collection of atoms or molecules. The function or application of active medium to collect the atoms or molecules which can be excited into a population inversion. The active medium can be in any state of matter, that is solid, liquid, gas or plasma. This is the example of active medium. The active medium, also called as gain medium, keeping your mind, gain. Active medium, also known as gain medium or lysing medium. Gain medium or lysing medium. Active medium is a source of optical gain within laser. Active medium is a source of optical gain within laser. Gain medium in laser compensate the resonator losses. Gain medium adds energy to amplified light by receiving some energy through pumping. When energy is supplied to laser medium, then only small fraction of laser medium shows lysing action. This part of the medium is called active medium. And active medium consists of lower level and upper level. So student, this is the diagram of activated level. This level shows the upper level, that is E2, and this is the lower level, that is E1. Now pumping method. The process of rising the atoms, rising the atoms from lower energy state to higher energy state is called pumping. The process of rising the atoms from lower energy state to higher energy state is called pumping. Then optical pumping, the process of rising the atoms, rising means increase. The process of rising the atoms from lower energy state to higher energy state excited using light medium. Excited using light medium is called optical pumping. Then this optical pumping, the process of rising the atoms from lower energy level to higher energy excited using light medium is called optical pumping. In case of optical pumping, generally for solid state laser, in optical pumping consist of solid state laser. And now I am going to start helium neon laser. Helium stand for He or He stand for helium. Neon stand for Ne, Ne stand for neon. So neon and helium, this is the name of elements. So helium neon laser consists of quarter tube having length 80 cm and diameter 1.5 cm. This tube is filled with mixture of helium and neon, that is 90 to 10 ratio. 10% and neon and 90% helium. So this is the ratio. This is the mixture of helium and neon gas in the quarter tube. And the size or dimension of the quarter tube is length is 80 cm and diameter 1.5 cm. So in this case, helium neon laser, gas atoms are characterized by the sharp energy level. As compared to the solid, for continuous laser beam, gas laser are used. The advantage of gas laser are high monochromaticity and stability of frequency. Helium neon laser is commonly used to read the barcode. This helium neon laser is generally used in the barcode. This lightly construction or shortly construction of helium neon laser. Helium neon laser consists of fused quarter tube having length of the about 80 cm and diameter of the tube is 1.5 cm. And student, the mixture of quarter tube of the gas helium and neon laser gas. So this mixture is very important and therefore it is called as helium neon laser. because this helium neon laser mixture is present in the cortex too in the ratio of 90 to 10. Keeping your mind, helium consists of 90% and neon consists of 10%. So student, today I stop here. Thank you very much.